Next, we are discussing about coupling types. Data coupling, two modules M1, M2 are coupled if they are communicated with parameter passing of input parameters. So, there are two modules M1 and M2. M1 and M2 passing input parameters. For example, M1 input parameters are passing to M2 or M2 input parameters are passing M1. Then the coupling is called as data coupling. Next one, stamp coupling. Stamp coupling means two modules M1, M2 are stamp coupling if they are communicated with passing information. They are communicated with passing information. So if two modules are passed input parameters or output parameters or internal or external parameters, then it is called as a stamp coupling. Next one, control coupling. Two modules M1, M2 are control coupled if M1 pass the control to the M2 or M1 pass the variable to the M2, then it is called as a control coupling. Control coupling means M1 pass the variable to the M2 or M1 pass the control to the M2. Common coupling. Two modules M1, M2 are sharing common data or global data. So global data means the data is declared as a public. So in C program, the data is declared as a declared above main function, then the data is called as global data. So in Java or C, the data is declared as a public, then the data is called global data. Two modules M1 M2 are sharing the common data or global data, then it is called as a common coupling. Next, content coupling. If M1, M2 are two modules, one module can change the content of the other module, then the coupling is content coupling. Content coupling means one module is change the content that is affected on the another module, then the coupling is called as content coupling. So the table description represents the level of coupling. So if no coupling, then the level is 0. Data coupling level is 1, stamp coupling 2, control coupling 3, common coupling 4, content coupling. So there are mainly 3 types of coupling. Low coupling, that means weakly coupling, and high coupling. So 0 is the low coupling and 5 is the highly coupling. Coupling ways. There are 3 ways to connect the modules. Interaction coupling occurs due to methods of classes invoking methods of other class. So one class method is invoked with other class, then the coupling is interaction coupling. Component coupling, interaction between the classes with variables. So two classes or two methods, two modules are interacted with the variables, then it is called as a component coupling. Inheritance coupling means deriving the properties from one module to another module, then it is called as inheritance coupling. Cohesion coupling is used to reduce the relation among two modules, whereas cohesion reduces the relation existing between the data elements in the module. So the main difference between coupling and cohesion, coupling is the range of or level of relation between the modules. Cohesion means the range of relation existing between the data elements in a module. Cohesion means the range of relation existing between data elements in a module. There are several levels of cohesion: no cohesion, high cohesion, and low cohesion. No cohesion means there is no relation. Highly cohesion means strong relation, and low cohesion means weakly relation. So these are the different types of cohesion: coincidental, functional, logical, temporally cohesion, procedural cohesion, and function cohesion. Coincidental cohesion, there is no meaningful relation between data elements. So in a module, elements are executed coincidentally, so then the cohesion is called coincidental cohesion. Logical cohesion, two or more modules are within the module or run with the same logic, then it is called as a logical cohesion. Temporally cohesion, same logic and run in same time. So two or more elements have a same logic and run at a time, then it is called as a temporally cohesion. Procedural cohesion means two or more elements follow the same procedure, so then it is called as a procedural cohesion. Functional cohesion, two or more elements are run with the same function, then it is called as a functional cohesion. Sequential cohesion, in which the output of one form is the input of other. The output of one element is gives the input of the other element in the module. So then it is called as a sequential cohesion. So there are three ways to represent the cohesion: method cohesion, class cohesion, and inheritance cohesion. Two or more elements are run with the same method, then the way is called method cohesion. Two or more elements run with the same class, then the way is called as class cohesion. Third one is inheritance cohesion, deriving the properties from one method to another method or one class to another class, then the cohesion is called, the way of cohesion is called as inheritance cohesion. Okay. Thank you so much.